Fine. Now, what should be the unit of solubility? We are saying it is the concentration of a given solute in a specified amount of solvent. Fine. Now, how do I express concentration?
Mass by mass, volume by volume, molarity,
mole fraction. So there are so many ways in which you are able to express the concentration, and hence you'll have so many ways of expressing solubility. Correct. So many a times in terms of solids, you'll normally find it is amount of grams maybe dissolved in some 100 grams of water per 100 grams of water, or many a times so many grams per liter of water, or many a times also mole in per liter or mole per kg. Okay, so you understand? So you can actually tell maybe the molarity. Correct. So in so much of solution, how much of something is gone. So you can say it is so much molar solution, and that will give you an idea of how much dissolved. And now you will understand the importance of molality. Molality says what? How much of solute in 1 kg of solvent? How many moles of solute in 1 kg of solvent? So you very well understand. See, and that's how maybe we prepare recipes, no? So suppose you are preparing certain amount of squash, you are normally given instruction that you take 1 liter of water, or say you can maybe reduce it and increase it. But suppose someone says you take a kg of water and put 150 ml of this particular squash. You understand? If I had told you molarity kind of thing, it would be difficult, because there I am telling you in 1 liter of solution. Now you don't know what to do. You put 150 ml of that, and suddenly the volume goes up. Okay, and many a times the volume is not the sum of the two. Okay, many times it is not. So it's better that sort of you are given molality, obviously, or grams per 1000 gram of solvent, pure solvent. So you take so much of water, take so much of this, and you just add it there. Obviously you'll be getting more than 1 kg of your whatever you're forming, the squash, right? So that is why these two had been defined in the first place. So we understand what our solubility is, and solubility depends on, so it depends on two things. It depends on number one. Yeah, apart from that, we now know that they are solute solvent specific, correct? But apart from that, it depends on temperature that we already know. Okay, so now I'm trying to relate it to the temperature. So it depends on temperature. It also depends on pressure. Okay, it also depends on pressure, but we'll soon see that for solid into liquid, the pressure thing is absolutely very, very negligible. So what we are doing currently, that is the dissolution of a solid solute particle into a liquid. We are trying to form what? A liquid solution, right? With solute being a solid. Now liquid solution could have been formed in three ways: solid, liquid, gas. all will be liquid solution. Okay, so in others it will become important, but not here. Fine. So pressure, the pressure, temperature is still relevant a lot. So solid in liquid, temperature plays an important role. Now try to understand what happens. Okay, suppose the dissolution is an endothermic process. What am I trying to say? If you put that, say, salt into something, say it is not exothermic, that means putting the salt does not release heat. Okay, fine. So what I'm saying is, if it is solute plus solvent plus energy giving me solution, this is what kind of process? This is endothermic. So if the process is,
it does not make it cold, right?
Endothermic. It does not make it cold, but see what happens. It will dissolve more of it if you heat it, more of solution gets formed. Okay, so if it is something like that, then what happens? Solute plus solvent plus energy gives me solution. Now if I heat it, so Lee Chatelier principle says what? If I heat it, if I give more energy, this energy will be consumed. What does the system try to do? It has the inertia, the exact same inertia as in physics. So what will it try to do? It will try not to change its temperature. So what will it do? It will absorb that energy and convert more of it into solution. Okay, so heating favors the forward reaction, that is formation of solution. And what happens? Delta H here is what? What is the delta H of this equation? For an endothermic, what is the delta H of the equation? Do you understand what delta H is? It is the enthalpy. What is enthalpy? Enthalpy is energy exchanged at constant pressure. Okay? It is energy exchanged at constant pressure. So here what happens? So it is actually calculated as energy of the product minus the energy of the reactant. What has happened? If you have energy here, okay? If you have put in energy, then what happens? The energy of the solution goes up, and here minus the product. So energy of the solution, that means the product, will be more than the energy of the reactant. So delta H here will be greater than zero. So by Lee Chatelier's principle. What does Lee Chatelier's principle say? It is nothing but the statement of the statement of inertia of the system. It says whatever you try to do to the reaction, it will try to oppose it. Okay. Yes. It is the pure inertia that any physical system shows or any electromagnetic system shows. So what it does, you try to push it in one direction, you apply some changes, it will move in such a direction that it tries to neutralize that change. It may not be able to neutralize it completely, but it will try to. Okay, so by Lee Chatelier's principle, the reaction will move in the forward direction, in the
forward direction.
So if the reaction is endothermic, what happens? It'll move in the forward direction. That means it'll favor the dissolution of the solute particles.
Fine. What if that is, it will dissolve more solute into the solvent?
What is an exothermic?
Exothermic reaction.
What happens in an
exothermic reaction? Solute plus solvent gives me
energy is exited, exo. Here it is entering, endo.
So it is solution plus
energy.
Now what happens here? What do you think will be delta H? This has actually released the energy. So the energy of the solution has to be less than that of the product of the reaction, has to be less than the reactant. So delta H has to be negative. And again, by the same Lee Chatelier's principle,
the reaction will move in backward direction. That is, it will favor crystallization.
Obviously, when it will dissolve more solute into the solvent, if we increase the temperature, right? Because if you increase the temperature, you are putting more energy into it, isn't it?
That is the solute. That is the solute molecules will come out of the solution if we increase the temperature.
If we increase the temperature, correct? Now, in the same, I'm writing here, there is another thing, pressure. What happens? We are talking about the solid particles and the liquid solvent, solid solute and the liquid solvent, which are highly incompressible. Okay?
The solid and the liquid are quite incompressible.
Solid and the liquid are quite incompressible, and hence what happens? And hence what will happen? The pressure in this case,
the pressure will not affect the solubility much.
Correct.